By a waterfall nestled deep into the mountainside, Sagat trains vigorously until he hears a noise coming from a nearby village. The young girl that Sagat has saved is gone. As he listens to the brother of the young girl plea for help, before Sagat's eyes, the very fabric of space and time warps, and a man suddenly appears before him. The man who has been entrusted with the will of Agni, Dalsim.
Sagat, Onushi ni tanomi wa?
Dalsim tells Sagat about the missing children from his own village. It appears to both of them that someone is trying to gather the world's strongest warriors and use their power to open the mysterious box, known as Pandora. To save the children, Dalsim and Sagat set out for the Antarctic, where the box is located.
Out of all the people who are looking for Pandora, you two seem to be the strongest!
I hate to deal with too many rivals at the South Pole. This is a perfect chance to thin out the numbers.
Whatever it takes!
And I really need to make some money!
I do.
You can't lose here!
Fight! Don't get in my way!
帝王の名は伊達ではない。
You win!
無事だったか。 我らをここに呼び寄せたのはこのためであったらしい。
Having safely rescued the children, Dalsim returns with them to his village. After the dust settles, life returns to normal. Following the events that took place in the Antarctic, Dalsim sometimes contemplates about the power of Pandora. Though he viewed it as the will of the gods that could grant power to people, it was also a power that could corrupt those who sought it. Could there ever be a time when such power would be useful? Perhaps if his village had come under threat again. But looking at the villagers surrounding him, Dalsim knew he had made the right choice. He resolved to rely on his own abilities to protect those around him.